I should have weakened his defense. No, we can build up to that. We can absolutely build up to that.
Sacred life.
24, holy shit.
Let my arrow fly in true.
That might have been one of the more impressive hits with that. 6,000. Oh, shit.
Interesting dilemma.
So that's 8. Just trying to keep a rough tally of the amount of damage. That's our 6. That's 14. And you get stronger, hey, between rounds. And you got a Lindy swipe to you, too, you prick. Wow. Oh, and you poisoned everybody. I hate. But only for, well, not everybody, but 2 people for 2 turns. That's not awful.
Out of my way.
Especially with the amount of healers that we got going in here.
Burn.
Gonna get you boosted up. Because Therion's gonna break it. We're gonna get some healing after this round of fighting.
Interesting dilemma.
Shite. Yeah, that'll be fine. It's gonna be back up right after this, though, so might as well just hit it with what I can. Another 4 grand off its ass. I wish I could weaken it before this. But that BP donation. There we go. Nice 6 grand right there. No, that works out pretty good. Because the kid's going to heal up, and then we can reduce its defense after. Yeah, you just hold... Yeah, your magic sucks. He was going to do maybe 800 per hit on that. Whoopty goddamn shit and do.
Witness the miracle of healing.
Patch everyone up pretty much to full. Hannet has too much goddamn HP, so... Strengthens its defenses a little bit more.
What's this now?
And now you're poisoned. Fantastic.
Great inferno to scorch the land.
How high can you get to strengthen your defense? That's a big question. Hit him with the magic? Hit him with magic. Why not? dagger, club, and sword. Really can't do too much in regard to that. Let's,
You're too kind.
500 HP and all that. Coming. God, he gets so much guessed. Shit back every time. It's great. I should have hit him with fire. What am I doing? God damn it.
A torrent of arrows.
Wouldn't have broken him anyways, but would have gotten just that much closer. God damn.
Sacred life.
Now he's gonna break him.
If thou darest.
No, you're gonna break him. Yeah.
My turn.
Okay. Yeah, let's start this off good. I don't think we're going to need this many turns to have him weakened, but this is going to hurt him a hell of a lot.
What's this now?
Oh yeah, this is going to be lovely. Wait, he's going to get another shot at that, so I'm not going to hit you with a big thing yet. Oh, this is going to be good.
Letting my arrow fly in true.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Alright, well, this is closest to the best I can hope for. 9,600. Bitch.
Out of my way.
I want over 10,000. I want over 10,000. Burn this fucker.
Let's do this. Burn.
Really, 2,000. for all that, 2,000 is the best you could give me. Upsetting. And that is that. I was hoping, if Hannet hit over 10,000, she could have definitely crushed that motherfucker's skull in with that. 1,000,000,000% believe that she could have. Oh.
This is a spot Balthazar marked on his map.
Green chest.
Wow! Whoa! It's gorgeous!
Oh?
And what's this? A letter?
Yeah!
Addressed to Mr. Leon! I'll make sure he reaches him.
Teleport us back to town? No. Letter from Balthazar and the... Now you're teleporting us back to... Alright. Convenient? Sure. Yeah, fought you already. I forget very quickly. Call it a inebriated brain that has that issue. That's all. Don't hold it against me. I got a problem.
Mr. Leon.
Voice actor, please.
I followed the map and found this.
Damn it. It has a shine spark.
Huh?
There's no mistake in it. This is the Elderite.
This was also in the chest.
A letter? A letter.
Did you ever find what's most precious to you?
You scallywag, son of a bitch. Oh, this is gonna be... Yeah,
Leon,
the music.
What's more precious to you than anything in the world?
Most precious? All my treasures are precious.
Yeah, but there has to be a most.
I didn't mean gold or gems, Leon.
Then what did you mean?
Do ye have something so dear to your heart that ye'd risk life and limb for it? When we were lads in that poor town, we thought having riches was all there was to life. But I've been wondering lately if that's the life worth living.
The one being hungry and destitute on the street? No, you have a different meaning behind that.
Then I wonder what life is worth living.
A life where you have fulfillment. A life where you have contentment. You don't have to be fulfilled, but content. You don't have to live every day like it's your last, but you... The ability to look back and see what your efforts, what the sweat of your brow, what you've done has produced, and what you leave behind, maybe. What there is behind, or at least through... children or wealth, ownership of things, or perhaps even a legacy. I just realized there's like a horrible bug where there's a section of the top right corner of the screen that's just not rendered out, which is weird, but okay.
I use me strength to steal from the weak. Just like ye, Leon. And it took years of looting to realize that none of it meant anything to me. Oh. Not everything that glitters is gold.
After the final race with Balthazar, I couldn't stop thinking about his last words. If I win, ye hand over your most precious treasure. But what was my most precious treasure? In the coming days, I kept asking myself the same question. never came to an answer. Until one day, I realized I'd obtained nothing. Just like Balthazar, I no longer had a reason to continue as a pirate.
I guess it came down to the distinguishment between precious and valuable. He has tons of valuable things. He has all these wondrous shiny baubles. But what is truly precious to you? Is it the how much wealth you've obtained? Or is it the wealth of the experiences that you've created, the relationships with people that you've built, or the legacies that you've left behind? That is precious. Valuable is another concept entirely on itself.
I lowered my flag. And I dedicated myself to repairing Balthazar's ship. I decided to pursue the dream of my friend in his stead. And so, I became the captain of a merchant ship.
You took up your friend's dream that I thought he may have intentionally given up.
I want you to keep that stone, lass.
Really?
It's so cute.
But it belonged to your friend.
This letter is all I need. That stone holds no meaning to me.
Are you sure?
It's valuable, but it's not precious.
Everyone has something precious to them.
Whether they know it or not.
Whether it be land, riches, honor, or what have you, there is an abundance of treasure in this world. But there is only space in one's heart for a single, truly precious treasure. And I found mine. Balthazar's ship. It gave me another chance at life.
Mr. Leon?
What is your most precious treasure?
I don't know. I got some gum.
It's...
Your ability to be an awesome merchant?
I don't know yet.
You are just a child.
But I know I'll find it someday.
Aye. With those keen eyes, I have no doubt you will. But be prepared. Your life will never be the same after.
No. It will be the beginning of new life.
Leon!
Farewell, lass.
Bon voyage! Toodaloo!
My most precious treasure.
Well, I am 14, so... I don't know, like my Barbie playset?
I saw Mr. Leon again. He taught me that there is only one true treasure in a person's life.
There's a precious treasure in one's life, not true treasure. I already mentioned the distinguishment in my mind what that is.
I haven't found that treasure in my life yet. But I'll keep searching until I do. It's just a matter of time now. With the Eldrite in hand, I'm ready for the auction.
Yeah. To Grandport we go.
Watch out, Merchant's Fair. Here I come.
That's a good read. Yes. Watch out, Redline! Here I come! Oh yeah, you're the shadowy figure from, Quarry, whatever the hell. Oh. You know, out of all the tales and revelations, stories and things that have occurred with the characters so far, that one has hit me the hardest. Holy shite. You know, I feel like I should get to Cyrus's because it's recommended level 40 now for his goddamn chapter 3. I think that will, as much as I hate to think that is the case, I'll jump into that when I'm ready for it. I just need a moment to make the rounds, but I'm almost certain that these missions kind of scale with the character, which is annoying because, well, you know, my lowest level character isn't even level 40, for Christ's sakes. Like, what do you expect to happen here? Sure, the current character and his status is 20 levels higher, but that's just annoying, man. Like, what are we looking at for everybody else? Alfin. Mind you, with the amount of XP that comes out of these, it's not going to make a huge difference, and he needs a whole different rework as well. Because I don't even think I have a job on him right now. No, he's running Hunter. He's running Hunter, and he's still about 990 away from completing his main job. Well, yeah, his primary job. Christ. Maybe not there. Alfin 32. Maybe before getting too high with him, consider going into that, because yeah, he's still pretty over leveled in respects. I'll get to that when I get to shit. I wanted to go to the shop and buy what I could, since, you know, have a shitload of money and such. just cocking about. All right, let's see what you got. Wait. Oh, I own everything that the shop has to offer. I'm going to run back to where I just was. Where is it? There we go. Stoneguard. Yes. Pretty sure I wasn't able to buy everything that the shopkeeper offers here. Or at least the armor? Weaponsmith? Christ, I don't even know if I've gone through this town on screen. This is all just grinding area for me going through this environment. Maybe, might have, perhaps. Okay, what we got that I do not own yet? That, no, and everything else I do own. Cool, well that was quick. Shit, I thought that was gonna burn a couple more seconds. Eh, that's something I can worry about with, grinding. We got Alfin in here, we just need to go see the local drinking hole. Get that up. Oh, yeah. Of the touching tales of friendship and camaraderie and such, that was the closest one where I'm like, oh boy, I'm really kind of tearing up on this. It hit me in a way where it's just, the concept is incredibly touching. I don't know how else to describe it. So this is Alfin's one, right? Hear a tale. Yeah. So his level 32, where he's 5 levels above that. Let's just do a little bit of a save now that we're in here. And let's get to that shit, shall we? Alfin, what are we ever going to do with you, dear sweet boy? Let's start your chapter 3. He's not the lowest one for completion, chapter 3, but chapter 4 he is, which is kind of surprising. Well, I don't know. I find that his story is a bit more compelling than a couple other people's, but the story so far. The deadly disease that plagued Goldshore, in the end, it was but the trickery of Vanessa, a depraved quack who enriched herself at her patient's expense. But Alvin put an end to her villainy and healed the people out of the kindness of his heart. You were always my hero, an unreachable ideal. But heck, if I ain't getting closer by the day. Having eased the pain and suffering of one town, Alfin strode into Saintsburg with newfound confidence. Little did he know what awaited him there. Ah, yes, Lower Saintsburg. Oh man, did you just run 10 feet? I know the feeling. Well, that looks like a traveling apothecary. Are you going to be on the up and up, or are all apothecaries I run across evil, manipulative bastards?
Hey, can you spare a scrap of food for a poor soul? As you can see, this Nyx left me too injured to stand.
I don't think a sandwich is going to fix that up for you, boy.
The wound festers. If it isn't treated, you'll be dead before the next sunrise.
It ain't that bad. It is just a scratch.
You're one of them apothecaries, is that it?
What's it to you?
Bloody hells, put the gods smile on me. Treat my wound, and you can name your price.
Before that, answer me one thing.
How did you get this wound?
Oh, of course, ask me anything.
Afraid you're out of luck, friend.
Oh. So, he's not evil, he just has a very, very strong moral compass in the sense where, you know, you're a bad person, and the world's better off without you. Oh.
Your life isn't worth saving.
That's rough, dude.
Wait, have some mercy. She can't just leave a man to die.
Can and will. Oh.
Hold it.
I've been listening the whole time. I could have probably come and help.
You're an apothecary, ain't you? How can you leave a man you examine to suffer?
And who in the hells are you?
I'm an apothecary too.
Name's Alfin, and despite appearances, I'm a traveling apothecary myself.
A fellow druggist, is it?
Eh.
Well, listen up. I'm a free man with the right to choose my patients.
What's that supposed to mean?
It's pretty clear cut, don't you think? Yeah, I don't think apothecaries fall under the Hippocratic Oath.
It means just what I said. Some lives aren't worth saving.
Now,
who does that jackass think he is?
But he's not going to be the antagonist here. It's probably going to be the redhead that we
You're
save.
You're an apothecary too, you said?
Maybe he can help me.
Sure am. And one who doesn't discriminate when it comes to those in need. Let me see that wound.
I got this killing all these children. Oh, their nails are so sharp and their fingers are so small.
Much obliged.
You're lucky I showed up when I did. There. That should give you a fighting chance. But you ain't out of the woods yet. You'll need plenty of rest till it heals up. Here, lean on me.
Aw, Alfin.
You're far too kind. Thank you.
The name's Alfin. Just doing my job.
Might be overdoing your job. I imagine that other apothecary has a very good justification for leaving this man to die. Oh, I'm Miguel. You really saved me.
Don't mention it. Just rest up now, okay? I'll check on you later with some victuals. I hear the grapes around these parts make for good eating. Oh, gonna have a full belly tonight.
Better for drinking, if you catch my meaning.
Hate to break it to you, but not in your condition, mister. No bows, swearing...
What? Even foul language?
Anything. Just Be a good person. We can raise a glass once you're all healed up, though. Deal?
Aye.
Aye, Elfin. I'd like that.
Heh. Now there's a friendly enough guy. He is a vile murderer.
Oh.
Shucks. I ain't eaten yet either. Neither. Hmm. Guess I should just go to the pub.
Oh, I thought it was like the middle of the night, judging how dark it is in there.
Can't mix medicine on empty stomach now, can we? Let's go hit the tavern.
Ooh, travel banter.
Hey.
Headed for the alehouse.
Nothing like a flag of meat to ease a man's cares.
I'm a regular at more than a few alehouses, though I go for rumors more than drink.
Rumors? What has anyone in the alehouse to say that interests a man like you?
Who's wealthy, for example, and who's not? Which lords pay their guards well and which don't?
You can find all that out at the tavern?
That and more. Mead loosens tongues and gets men talking. There's quite some profit to be had in an alehouse, even if you know how to listen. Not to mention thieves themselves often drop by to share secrets and tips.
Yikes! I best be careful the next time I'm quenching my thirst.
Heh, you can try.
Either way, I'll be counting my mugs if you and I ever go drinking.
What the? Oh! I thought you meant like, oh, you're gonna try to steal some of my booze. And it's like, no. That's not what he means. So we got a mission over here. Oh, it's this woman screaming for help, eh? Yeah, I don't remember what your deal is still. So I guess I'll deal with that later. I'll have to look into my quest log at some point and figure out what the hell this wailing woman is bleeding about all the time. Because honestly, I cannot remember. To the alehouse! Oh, ho, 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 ho. Some good mead here.
What's this now?
What's all the hubbub? Bub? Hey, what happened here?
Someone, help!
My son, he just collapsed. I sent for help, but oh, look at him, he's dying.
Let me take a look.
There's an apothecary in the house. Let me see him at once.
What?
Truly?
Doesn't seem to be a case of food poisoning. But then what could it be?
Oh dear.
Does your son suffer from any afflictions or ailments, ma'am?
No,
at least none that I know of.
Damn it all.
Think, Elfin, think.
And this guy outclasses me.
In. Where's the patient?
Just trying to pick a...
Where's the patient?
No, I'm not going to go with that. That's kind of a bad Shatner.
Oh. Huh? You're that sham from before.
You
again. As for whether or not I'm a sham, you can judge for yourself.
Yeah, I'm going to go with the bad Shatner. Fine.
I see. Seems to be a paroxysm of some sorts. Doubtless brought on by something he ate. Sweet peas are known to cause this reaction in some people. Here, this should set things right.
Whoa.
Well, I'll be. He is a good apothecary. But why did you leave that other guy to die? Where am I?
Oh.
By the gods.
Oh, my.
Timothy, you're all right. Oh, sir. I have not the words to thank you.
Just doing my job.
It's nothing. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Oh, boy. This is going to be bad.
The name's Ogin, traveling apothecary. And I trust you've learned not to judge a man before you know him.
Well, shucks. Don't I look like a grade A sucker?